our website provides details about stores open during the lockdown and that provide home delivery, and our site is functional at coronahelp.in. As you can see here, we have an option to add your store.
So shop owners can add details about their stores.
So in this way, you can add a store to the list. Now users can search for stores open in a particular area.
For example, if you look at stores open in Belgaum city.
Now suppose you want to search for stores providing medicines through home delivery, you can apply the filters and you get a list of medical shops providing home delivery. We are also working on a system to place orders for your groceries online, so you can build your own grocery list and you can either place your order online and collect it at the store, or if the store is providing home delivery, it will be delivered to your house. Now you can build your list here in this manner. Suppose you want to add milk. Once you are done building your shopping list, you can submit your order and the order will be submitted to the store and you will get an ordering ID. So this ID needs to be shown at the store or when the order is received at your house, and the billing will be handled by the shop itself.
Problem which we actually tried to solve is something which many people including us faced during the initial days of lockdown. It was actually becoming difficult even to get our hands on a packet of milk. So this is how the idea was actually born. Initially, we were using a few Google APIs to improve the user experience, but it turned out to be very cost inefficient. So the cost for keeping the website running was increasing very rapidly because of the traffic we were having. So then a college senior told me about a few open source mappings which are available. So then using those open source mapping itself, we had to develop our own like the Google autocomplete API features.
Who could have thought that we could have a hackathon right from our homes, having almost the same experience as you would attending a physical one?
Biggest problem was gaining critical mass around our website.
We used social media platforms at our disposal. We prepared a few messages in local languages and we circulated them. And with the help of our college, we also managed to get featured in a few local newspapers. And as a result, we were able to get almost 100 stores on our website within a few days. And we also got 10,000 visits within 3 days.
My parents were quite happy, and even I got the calls from many of my relatives congratulating me for taking this initiative, and they actually encouraged me and told me to keep on going.
My parents have always been very supportive. In fact, they encouraged me to participate in such competitions and hackathons. And my father always tells me that your education is of use the day you can make a difference to somebody. So I think my parents are happy that I'm using this time productively. The fact that we were able to use our skills hands-on to build something that could actually help someone somewhere in whatever little way possible was a really rewarding experience, and it was humbling.
The people who spend their free time, I think they don't embrace the technology. I mean, like if they really read or explore something, and if they are really fascinated by it, I'm sure they would give up their laziness to learn it more. So I think the main thing which people these days are not doing is that they have stopped exploring. They're just stuck around a few social media and it just passes their time. They're not interested in exploring the new stuff which is coming out and which they could be fascinated in if they read about it more.
I think that there's an immense potential among our students out there just waiting to be tapped. So the eYantra Hackathon is the perfect platform that taps into that potential and motivates us to innovate, to build something unique, and at the same time learning to follow a deadline. So I think that it's a really unique experience, and it also encourages us to use our skills to bring about change.